There are a few causes for your car's engine to continuously turn over, but show no signs of life. The battery or alternator usually causes car starting problems. But when the car cranks but won't start, that's not always the case. There are several issues that can lead to this unusual circumstance, and each has an appropriate solution. In this video, we take a closer look at the top 5 causes car turns over but won't start. We also describe how to find the problem and fix it. It's the Car Problems YouTube channel. Subscribe and let's get started. Lack of fuel. Fuel must enter the combustion chamber in order for the engine to start. To ensure proper combustion, the fuel and air must mix. If fuel cannot reach the engine, you may hear the engine try to crank but it won't start. One of the most frequent issues that could prevent gas from reaching the engine is a bad fuel pump. Gas can no longer be pumped through the system when the pump breaks down. However, the issue might be as straightforward as a clogged fuel filter. Injector clogs are another factor in low fuel levels. These nozzles become blocked by corrosion, rust, and debris. Furthermore, poor fuel can lead to issues with the injectors, which is why it's crucial to purchase gas from top-notch stations. Some people use common additives in an effort to avoid fuel injector clogs. Low compression. The right amount of compression is also necessary for the engine, in addition to air, fuel, and spark. You'll have a lot of trouble starting the engine if there isn't enough compression. Leaky gaskets or seals may be the cause of low compression. To get everything running again, you might need to replace the valves or the piston rings. Battery power issues. A dead battery will undoubtedly result in an unstartable engine, but it may not always allow the motor to turn on. However, you can't rule out the possibility that the battery is only now beginning to lose power. In this situation, there might be sufficient power to turn it but not start it. Cables that are corroded or damaged can still result in a problem even if the battery is in good shape. You can decide whether the terminals or cables need to be handled with a quick inspection. Ignition problems. If the fuel system is working properly, the ignition could be the problem. The spark plugs are typically fouled or contaminated. There wouldn't be enough spark to start the engine because the plugs would be required to ignite the fuel-air mixture. While some plugs have a rating of 100,000 miles or more, others are only good for about 30,000 miles. The wires may also be the issue if your car is older. Alternately, newer models could also be the cause since they use ignition coils to power the plugs. Bad ignition timing. We've already talked about how crucial a spark is for starting the engine, but the spark also needs to be precisely timed. The fuel-air mixture won't burn properly if it occurs too early or too late. A broken crankshaft position sensor is one of the main causes of incorrect firing. This sensor provides the computer with information about the piston and valve position, enabling precise timing of the spark. The computer won't know when to ignite the spark plugs if the sensor malfunctions, making it difficult to start the engine. The timing chain plays a significant role in ignition timing as well. The majority of chains are rated for the lifetime of the vehicle, but this does not preclude their eventual failure. How to fix a car that cranks but won't start. To avoid being stranded, you need to identify the cause of the car's failure to start. The diagnostics aren't too difficult for most people, especially if they have a little mechanical knowledge. Here are some actions you can take using some fundamental tools and information. However, it's acceptable to contact a professional if you believe that any of these tasks are beyond your capabilities. You can always decide later on whether you want to handle the repair work yourself after paying the diagnostic fee. Read trouble codes. Some of these errors will result in the computer setting a code. If your dashboard has a warning light, you might be able to diagnose the issue using your code scanner. Connect your OBD2 scanner to the port underneath the steering wheel if it is compatible. To figure out the issue, read the codes and do some online research. You can still see what has been set in the computer even without a code scanner. Drive to the closest auto parts store and request a free system scan there. Check spark. Use a spark plug tester to check for spark. The instructions are straightforward. Here are some general instructions that you can use. 1. Engine cover should be removed. 2. Look for the spark plugs. The spark plugs on most four-cylinder engines are located on top of the engine. With an inline 6, the same is valid. The cylinders will be located on either side of the engine if it has a V6 or V8 configuration. 3. Unplug the fuel injectors. 4. From the plug you intend to test, remove the ignition coil. It is still able to be wired to the wiring harness. 5. Interconnect your inline spark plug tester with the ignition coil and the plug. While performing the test, avoid touching the ignition coil or spark tester. 6. Ask a helper to start the engine and try to crank it. 7. Look for the indicator on the test light when the engine is attempting to start. If it reacts, a spark results. Other components besides the spark plugs may also have flaws. The ignition coil's failing is also not uncommon. Check fuel pressure. you need a pressure gauge to check for problems with the fuel system. If the pressure is low, you will also need to determine which component is at fault. Some sophisticated code scanners also allow you to view the fuel pressure. You can examine the pressure to determine if there is a problem. While some pressure problems can be easily fixed at home, others might need a specialist assistance. Charge the battery. You should turn your attention to the battery if there are no codes present or none that relate to a cranking issue. Start by quickly examining the connections. There should be no corrosion and they should all be in place. If you notice corrosion, use a solution of baking soda and water to remove it. Check compression. You need more sophisticated methods and tools to check engine compression. The majority of DIY mechanics won't have the right equipment to measure compression accurately. Because of this, you might prefer to go to your local auto repair shop right now. You can almost always be sure that compression is the issue by first ruling out issues with the other systems. Hope the information was useful for you. If so, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel.